good evening, and welcome to Sportsline Radio. My name is Dave, the MeatMan Scandaliato, and I am broadcasting live right here on 910 AM WUBR CBS Sports Radio, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. The phone number here, if you want to jump in a ball game, 225-928-4910, 225-928-4910. And, well, you know, we don't have much football to talk about here. We got the Super Bowl, and that's going to be played next week. And, of course, we got the Pro Bowl. We do have the Pro Bowl. That's going to be played this week, and I do have the point spread and the over-under on the Pro Bowl. So we got, you know, we got some stuff to talk about. And then, of course, we got some NBA tonight. I've been doing all right on the program with the NBA plays. 2-0 last week right here on the program. So we're going to see if we keep that up. I'm going to try to make sure I get to the NBA segment a little earlier this week. I might even start the show out with it today. And of course we got college basketball. I'm waiting on the official LSU Tigers Texas Tech Red Raiders point spread. I should be getting that sometime pretty soon here, and as soon as I get it, I will be releasing that right here on the program. So we got a lot of stuff to talk about today. We got a lot of stuff that we need to cover, but as always, before we get the party started, I would just like to quickly remind everybody that the following information is to be used as news material only and is not intended to violate any state, federal, or local laws. All right, the Pro Bowl. Let's talk a little bit about the Pro Bowl here. Because, you know, whether you like it or not, it's going to be on TV. People are going to watch it. And people are going to bet on it. And right now at Bookmaker, which is where the line originates, the NFC is a 4-point favorite. The total on the game is 83. The line opened 4 and 82.5. So you got to give Bookmaker credit. They got the total. They got the total right. That's not easy to do, man. That's not easy to do. Get the over under right on a Pro Bowl. But they got to give them credit. You got to give them credit. Credit's due. They nail that. I mean, a lot of people are saying, well, what did they said 82.5, it went to 83. All right. But, I mean, a lot of places still have the 82.5. A lot of places still dealing the opening number from Bookmaker, from Chris. So I got to give him credit. I don't really have a pick in the game. I really don't like anybody. I don't like betting the Pro Bowl. Like I said, for a couple of years, when they were doing it differently, when they were drafting the players and it was kind of like a big deal, at least of the two guys, Deion Sanders. I forgot who the other guy was. It was Deion and one of these other dudes, and they kind of made it personal and all that, but I think they made it too personal. So obviously the odds makers are thinking that it's going to be back to some high score. And 83 points, that's a lot of points. A lot of people going, man, that total last week with Atlanta and Green Bay, it was 62. Yeah, this was 83. This one's 3 touchdowns higher. But I don't know. I mean, what kind of Pro Bowl is it when all the good players don't play? It's not much of a Pro Bowl. It's not much of a Pro Bowl. But if you do want to bet it, right now the spread is 4. Some places do have a 4.5. And the total is 83. They do still have, they got an 81.5 out there. They got a lot of 82.5s out there. And they got a lot of 83s out there. So they got you got a mixture. I mean, if you want over the total, you don't want the 83. You want to find somewhere that's got the 82.5, or go to the MGM, who's got the 81.5. Remember, the MGM, that's the Mirage, Mandalay Bay, the Bellagio, the Luxor. It's a lot of places. It's a lot of places. A lot of people don't realize that. The Clown Joint, the Circus is an MGM property. And that's where I'll be broadcasting the program from next week. They don't know nothing about it. They don't know anything about it. They don't know nothing about it. But that's where I'm going to broadcast the program from. The Clown Joint. That's right. I'm going there for 8 days. I'm going to see the clowns. Yeah, I could stay somewhere nicer, but it would cost me more. I mean, what do you think? I mean, look, I could stay at the Clown Joint with all of my comps and everything. I got to pull every string known to man to do this. I could stay at the Clown Joint for 8 days for under $400. Or I could go stay at the Mandalay Bay for $1,500. I mean, it's a no-brainer to me. It's a no-brainer. Plus, you got to remember, everybody charges for parking now in Las Vegas. Caesars Palace, Harrah's, Bellagio, all of these places. Mandalay Bay, MGM, they all charge for parking. The Clown Joint, they don't charge for parking. No parking charge at the Circus, because, man, if they did charge for parking, I don't think anybody would go. I mean, let's be brutally honest. It's hard enough to get people to go over there. Of course, if you got kids, it's a really good place because, you know, like if you're in another casino and you're walking through there with your kids, security will come up and they'll go, excuse me, folks, children can't be allowed to gaming machines. You need to move. But if you got a trapeze act going over your head and they got a couple of clowns in the place, your kid can stand right next to the poker machine. It's amazing how it works. It's amazing. It's the funniest thing in the world. As long as they got trapeze going on over your head and clowns and balloons and all that, your kids can stand right there by the machine. But not in Caesar's Palace, man. Holy Toledo, Guacamito, baby. But that's right. When you go to Las Vegas now, you got to pay to park. No more free parking. You pull your car up in valet. You're one of these guys. You're big time. You're a high roller. You're one of these big time guys. You're one of these big time guys. Well, the bottom line is now you got to pay to park. $20 a day. Can you believe that? You got to pay $20 a day to park your car. You got to pay $20 a day to park your car. Yeah, I mean, Vegas, look, believe me, they nickel and dime people to death. They nickel and dime you to death. Now, $30 to valet park your car. $30. Can you imagine this? Can you imagine this? You got to pay $30. $30 to park your car in Las Vegas. You got to pay $30. $30. You pull up at the Caesars Palace, $30. You want to park it? And that's a day. Ain't no $30. You pull a car there, you stay 4 or 5 days, and then you check out. Now you got to give them $150, man. You got to give them $150. You got to give them 150 smackaroos, man. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable what they're doing out there in Las Vegas. So, all right, let's see. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Super Bowl line. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Super Bowl line here. We got the New England Patriots and the Atlanta Falcons going at it. And it looks like the spread everywhere you go is 3. Looks like the spread everywhere you go is 3 points. Looks like the spread no matter where you go, no matter what you do, it's going to be 3 points. It's going to be 3 points. I'm looking at the screen right here. And let's see. I'm looking at the screen. Everybody's got a 3. You got the Cantor Gaming. You can get New England -3, -$1.05, which means you only got to bet 105 to win 100. If you want to take the New England Patriots, There was the Coast Casino. They actually had it yesterday at 3 even money. You could have got the New England Patriots minus 3 even money. You would have had to take the Atlanta Falcons plus 3 minus $1.20, but somebody must have came in and scooped that up. See, that's why nobody's going to move off of the 3. It's going to take an act of Congress to get this thing off of the 3. It's going to take an act of Congress. I mean, it's going to be tough to get this thing off of 3 points, because as soon as they move it, somebody's just going to bet it. They're going to bet it unless there's a steady flow. Unless there's a steady flow. But if one place dares to come off the number, somebody's going to back the truck. I mean, why wouldn't you take New England? I mean, as soon as the Coast Casino, and that's the Gold Coast, that's the Fremont, the California Club, Main Street, that's the Orleans. I mean, they got a few casinos around town. The Coast Casinos, they got a few around town. And but man, as soon as they went to 3 even money, boom, somebody came in there and popped it and put it right back on 3 minus $1.10. So it's 3, man. I mean, there's no 3.5s out there. There's no 2.5s. They do have the 3.5 at the Treasure Island. If you want Atlanta plus 3.5, you can go to the Treasure Island, but you got to lay $1.35 to get it. You got to lay $1.35 to get it. You got to lay $1.35 to win a dollar on Atlanta if you want the 3.5. But if you want the Patriots, you can lay the 3.5 and take them plus $1.15. So instead of betting 110 to win 100, you're betting 100 to win $1.15. You're flipping the juice by 25 cents. That half a point costs you 25 cents, man. That's a lot of money for a half a point. That's a lot of money, 25 cents. 15 cents used to be the norm to buy on or off of 3. They used to charge you 10 cents to buy off any number. You wanted to move it from 5 to 5.5, or 5.5 to 6, or 4 to 4.5, or 4.5 to 4. Used to cost you 10 cents. And then if you wanted to buy on or off of 3, on or off of 7, they used to charge you 15 cents. Now they want to charge you 25 cents. It's just too much. Now you got to remember, Tom Brady, he's 2-4 against the spread in the Super Bowl. He's 2-4. That's not that good. He won outright against the St. Louis Rams as a 14-point underdog. And then he beat the Seattle Seahawks on an absolute miracle. And that game basically was a picket. And with New England winning the game, they covered the spread. But New England, their 2 losses against the New York Giants, they lost as the favorite. And then, of course, when they played the Carolina Panthers, they were a 6-point favorite, won their game by 3. And when they played the Philadelphia Eagles, they were a 5-6-point favorite, and they didn't cover the spread. I don't remember off the top of my head what exactly happened, but I know Donovan McNabb and the Eagles scored a late touchdown. The MeatMan had the Eagles in that game. It's one of the few times that the team that didn't win the game actually covered the spread. Remember, the team that has won the game so far this year in the NFL playoffs is 10-0. No team has lost and covered. If the underdog covered the spread, they won the game outright. And if the favorite won the game, they covered the spread. So, you know, 10-0 in the NFL playoffs, if you just can pick the outright winner of the game, you're also 10-0 against the spread. But New England, one of the few teams, obviously, once again, they're 0-2 when they lose a Super Bowl, but just 2-2 against the spread when they've actually won the Super Bowl. So you got to be careful with the Patriots. You got to be careful with New England. New England's a sneaky team, man. You know, once again, they barely beat the Carolina Panthers. The score was, what, 0-0 with about 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. And then all of a sudden, it was just a big explosion of points. I mean, you talk about a dead under. This thing was an absolute dead under. If you had under the total in the New England Patriots-Carolina Panthers game in that Super Bowl, you were looking so good with just a couple of minutes to go in the first half, and then it was unbelievable. I mean, if you had a super teaser, it went over the total. So, that was a game they won by three. So, you know, I don't know what to think here. Personally, off the top of my head, I think New England's going to win the game. I think New England's going to beat Atlanta. It just looks like no matter who New England plays, they're just going to win the game. It just looks, no matter who they play, they just go out there and they just beat them. They just beat them. No matter who they play, they just seem to be able to go out there and beat them. I don't know. I don't know. They just seem to just go right out there, boom, 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 win the game. I mean, this dude Hogan, I never even heard of this dude. Some white guy. Saw that? Some white guy catching all the touchdowns the other day. I couldn't believe it. They'd run a flea flicker. They'd throw, that's a white guy. Hey, the first touchdowns with a white guy. Who's this? Hogan. Who is this guy? Never heard of him. So, I don't know, man. I mean, you figure Tom Brady, this is his seventh Super Bowl. Matt Ryan's first. Hey, you know, Tom Brady's been there before. And, you know, they say, well, he went 10 years before beating Seattle, and they shouldn't have beat Seattle. Maybe that'll be the motivation that Tom Brady needs. Because everybody says, well, he shouldn't have won the last one. Well, yeah, they should have, because the final score had New England winning the game. You know, look, I mean, that interception, that's just part of football. You could say, hey, Seattle got lucky to get down there. They throw the ball, it bounces off the guy's chest in the air, and this and that. He catches it lying down and all that. Hey, you know, look, you're going to have lucky plays in a football game. You're going to have unlucky plays in a football game. That's just how it goes, man. That's just how it goes. You're going to have lucky plays. You're going to have unlucky plays. And when a guy made the interception, Malcolm Butler, hey, that wasn't luck, man. That was a hell of a play, man. That was a great play. And I had Seattle. That play cost me about, not too much, but it cost me about a dime, cost me about $1,000. It hurt. It doesn't hurt, you know, believe me. You lose money all the time when you're gambling. You win, you lose. You win, you lose. I mean, some days you look like a dead winner and you wind up losing. Some days it looks like you not going to win anything, and then through the grace of God, a miracle of Jesus, some kind of way, you cover the spread. So you got to take your wins, and you got to act like you've been there before, and when you take the loss, you can't take it too personal, man. You got to get back up on the bike and keep pedaling. And but I'm never going to forget that. I'm never going to forget standing there watching the guy for New England intercept that ball. I'm never going to forget it. I don't know if I was in the clown joint, in the circus, or I was in the Riviera. I'm not sure which one I was at. I can't quite remember where I was, but I'll never forget the play. Never. They should have ran the ball. There's no doubt about it. They should have ran the ball. They should have just hiked it, pitched it to the guy in the backfield, and boom, he gets the half a yard. He's in the end zone. The meat man starts doing the boogie-woogie. And that's the end of that. Instead, said a couple of curse words, took the tickets, threw them in the garbage. And that was the end of that. All right, we got to take a break. We got to take our first commercial break for 2 days' program. When we come back, we're going to talk a little NBA basketball. I got at least two plays going tonight in the NBA, including a pick in that New Orleans Pelicans-San Antonio Spurs matchup. You want to jump in a ballgame, 225-928-4910, 225-928-4910. You are listening to Sportsline with Dave the Meat Man Scandaliato. And you're doing it right here, Cap, 910 AM WUBR, CBS Sports Radio, Baton Rouge. Yeah, did you hear the phone ringing? No, yeah, it kept ringing and ringing and ringing and ringing. I don't know who the fuck that was. It wasn't you. But, yes, I'm over at the, if you want to call and tie the line up, that'd be good. All right, can you hear me? All right. So you don't come in for the post game show? You don't come in for that? Thank you. All right. Let's see. We got the LSU line came out. And LSU is 15. 16. Jesus, 16. Jeez of criminies. Wow. 16. That's not good. That's not good for the Tigers because Texas Tech, they ain't any good. Jesus. Let's see. The early money came in on LSU, man, 15.5. 15.5. Obviously, somebody who knows nothing about basketball made a bet. All right. And welcome back to Sportsline. My name is Dave, the MeatMan Scandaliato, and I'm broadcasting live like I do every Friday, 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Central Time on 910 a.m. WUBR CBS Sports Radio right here in Baton Rouge. Next week, I'll be broadcasting live from Las Vegas. That's right, I'm going back for the Super Bowl. I'm going back sometime in the near future. I'm not exactly sure when I'm going back permanently, but I am going for the Super Bowl. I'm going to go back up there. I missed New Year's Eve up there for the first time in 15 years, but I wasn't going to miss the Super Bowl, man. I wasn't going to miss that. I want to go out there. I want to bet the games. I want to bet the props. If you want to bet on the Super Bowl props, give me a call. 702-609-0930. 702-609-0930. I'll tell you exactly what you need to do. I like betting the props. There's a prop right here. Over under beers, pills, and doobs smoked by the meat man on Super Bowl Sunday. The over under is 25.5. Jesus, criminies. Well, if you think about it, 3 doobs, 4 pills, 17 beers. I mean, hey, that's 24 right there. I'd probably drink 18 beers. That'd probably be an 18-beer day. Drink 18 beers, couple of dubs, couple of things. You know, my back, for my back, not to get loaded. It's for my back. I got a bad back. Come on. All right, now look. Immediately following LSU's loss tomorrow. I got the line right here. LSU, the line at Bookmaker, opened at 16. Texas Tech minus 16 against LSU. The total, 154.5. And immediately the sharps and the wise guys pounce on the LSU Tigers, and they drive the line down to 15.5. Yep, the line opened 16 and 154.5. It's now holding steady at 15.5 and 154.5. Now, immediately following the ball game, the post game show, sponsored by Pelican Sports TV, right here on 910 AM WUBR CBS Sports Radio, Baton Rouge. It's going to start at about 3 p.m. Central Time. Tommy Chrysan, TK, Jordy Holberg, taking your calls, taking your text messages. The postgame show is also going to be played in over 1 million homes in the state of Louisiana on Pelican Sports TV. Yep. It's like going to a jazz funeral without the band. Talking about LSU basketball. LSU football? Hey, LSU football's all right. You know, it's not bad. Not bad. You know, the gymnastics team ranked number one. Baseball team ranked up there in the top 10, top five, you know. But, boy, I don't know what happened to the basketball team. It's hard to believe you can't get a basketball team together. It's hard to believe you can't find 12 guys that could play a little basketball. It's hard to believe. But I guess LSU's not a basketball school. Even though Shaquille O'Neal went there, probably arguably the most recognizable NBA player out there today. And LSU's basketball program, where he went to school, is absolute garbage. I said it. There you go. I mean, it's bad. It's bad. I mean, the other day, somebody called me on the phone, and they said, MeatMan, I know you like betting on them home dogs. He said, what about LSU and the 12 against Florida? I said, you got to be kidding yourself. Look, no chance. I told him, I said, don't do it, man. They said, oh, no, that's a lot of points here, the Tigers. I said, man, this is a different Tiger team right here, man. This is definitely not the same LSU Tigers in basketball as we've seen in the past. And, boy, they got crushed, man. They got absolutely crushed. I didn't bet on Florida, but I did talk several people off of betting on Florida. But, hey, look, right after the game, I know there's a lot of people that live and die purple and gold. Believe me, I live in a house with a guy that dies green and blue, okay? So, I mean, I know what it's all about. Unfortunately, if Tulane had a post-game show for that basketball, I mean, there wouldn't be anybody listening. I don't even think the coach or the team, I don't even think you could find a guy to host the thing to be You talk about Tulane and LSU ought to play each other. They ought to play each other. They ought to play each other to find out which team is worse. That's what they ought to do. That's what Tulane and LSU ought to do. Maybe if they have a break coming up, the two coaches ought to call each other and say, the meat man can't figure out who sucks more in basketball, Tulane or LSU, and let them settle it on the court. Let them settle it on a basketball court, man. Let's find out once and for all which one of these two teams is more garbage than the other. LSU would probably be about on a neutral floor. I'd say LSU would probably be about a 7-point favorite. They'd be about a touchdown favorite. I know it's basketball, but they'd be about a 7-point favorite. I mean, you couldn't lay 10 with the Tigers. I mean, you'd have to have your head examined. So you don't want to make it too high. But, of course, man, Tulane basketball, they're bad, man. They're bad. I mean, they're LSU bad. They're bad. I mean, let's just call it like it is. I mean, they're bad. Maybe we can get this game together. Maybe we can make it a charity event. Maybe we can make it some kind of charity event. We'll give a charity some money or something like that. We'll give them the proceeds from the gate. If we could find anybody that would actually pay, they'd go see it, boy. All right, but immediately following the LSU game, 3 p.m. Central Time, Pelican Sports TV presents the post-game show. 3 p.m. Central Time, Tommy Chrysan, Jordy Holberg, taking your calls, taking your text messages on Pelican Sports TV. A million homes, 1 million. Man, I got to take my shoes off to count that high. That's how many homes Pelican Sports TV is in, 1 million homes across the state of Louisiana. And then, of course, you're listening to the program right here, 9:10 a.m. WUBR CBS Sports Radio in Baton Rouge. The one thing I didn't touch on as far as the over-under was concerned in the Super Bowl is how high it is. I mean, this thing is one click away from going to 60. The Westgate's got a 59. The Mirage has a 59. Stations has a 59. Pinnacle's got 58. You got Bookmaker. They're sitting at 58. I tell you, man, that's a lot of points, man. That's a lot of points. I mean, I'll be the first guy to admit, both of these teams can score. The Atlanta Falcons, you know, they average 34 points a game, and they give up 24 points a game. The Patriots, they average 28 a game, but they only give up 15 points a game. They're very stingy, the New England Patriots. Now, these two teams haven't met since 2013. They met in September of 2013, and the New England Patriots went into Atlanta and defeated the Falcons 30-23. In that game, the total was 49. New England covered the spread. The game went over the total. Outside of that, I mean, these two teams really don't play a lot. In the last 10 years, they've only played twice in the regular season. New England beat them the other time at home, 26-10. That was in 2009. They played a preseason game in 2006, and Atlanta won 26-23. And then they played a preseason game in 2010 that New England won 28-10. So you don't really have a lot of information to go on. You know, like last week, or whatever it was, 2 weeks ago, you had four rematches of teams that had played in the regular season. Well, in this particular case, these two teams didn't play all of 14, all of 15, all of 16, and all of 17. And let's be honest with you, they met in September of 2013. So these two teams haven't met each other in 5 years, basically. Preseason, regular season, postseason, no season. It doesn't matter what season it was. These two teams don't play each other. So you don't have nothing to go on. You really don't have nothing. You don't have nothing to go on. Of course, both teams are riding big-time winning streaks. The New England Patriots have won 9 games in a row. Their last loss was at home against the Seahawks. That was a revenge game for Seattle. We had that game. That was one of our big plays during the NFL regular season. New England was giving Seattle 7.5 points. I think we can all agree New England was the better team at the time, but 7.5 points, that's a lot of wood, brother. That's a lot of pipe to give a team like the Seahawks. So the Patriots have won 9 in a row, while the Atlanta Falcons, they have won 6 in a row. Their last loss was that game against the Kansas City Chiefs when Matt Ryan and the Falcons were going for 2. They were up 28-27. They scored a touchdown to go up by 1. They were going to go for 2 to make it a 3-point game. Matt Ryan threw an interception, and the guy for the Chiefs took it back to the house the other way for deuce, for safety. And instead of the score being what it was, the Chiefs took a 1-point lead, and they wound up holding off the Atlanta Falcons. So both teams are hot right now. Both teams are hot. During their 6-game winning streak, Atlanta beat the Rams, the 49ers, the Panthers, the Saints, the Seahawks, and the Packers. They scored 42 on the Rams, 41 on the 49ers, 33 on the Panthers, 38 on the Saints, 36 on Seattle, and 44 on Green Bay. That's impressive. That's impressive. But what's even more impressive is the fact that New England, during their 9-game winning streak, they gave up 17 to the Niners, 17 to the Jets, 10 to the Rams. They did give up 23 to the Ravens. They gave up 3 to the Broncos, 3 to the Jets, 14 to the Miami Dolphins, 16 to the Houston Texans, and 17 to the Pittsburgh Steelers. And the last four games that the Patriots have played, they scored 41 against the Jets, 35 against the Dolphins, 34 against the Houston Texans, who had the best defense in the league, and then put up 36 points against the Pittsburgh Steelers. So, man, I tell you, New England scores a lot of points, but they don't give up a lot of points. Atlanta, they score a lot of points, but, you know, they gave up 21 to Green Bay, 20 to Seattle, 32 to the Saints, the last game of the season. So I can see why they set the total high. But if New England's defense shows up to play, and New England's defense plays as good as they have been playing, because, I mean, once again, in the Patriots' last five games, they've given up 53 points. It's 10.5 points a game, man. And with a total at 58, 59, and one team's only given up 10.5 points their last five games, that means you got to count on that team to score 50. You got to count on that team to score 50 points if you wanted to go over the total. Now, obviously, we're going to talk all about this next week when I'm going to be broadcasting live from the Circus Hotel and Casino. Don't tell them, man. It's a secret. It's a secret. It's a secret. Don't tell them. It's a secret. It's a secret. We're going to be broadcasting live from the Circus Hotel and Casino. I'm going to have all the prop bets. I'm going to have prop bets coming out of the eyeballs, man. We're going to have prop bets coming out all over the place. I mean, it'll be like a big prop-a-thon. I'm going to have all sorts of stuff for everybody next week. So don't forget, 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Central Time next Friday. Sportsline live from Las Vegas, Sin City, the sports and gaming capital of the United States of America. I'm going to be doing a program, and I'm looking forward to it, man. We're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to have a lot of fun next Friday here on the show. All right, now we got to take one more break. We got to take one more break. When we come back, we're going to talk a little NBA basketball. I'm going to pick the Pelicans-Spurs game. I'm going to go ahead and pick that, and then I might pick the Philadelphia 76ers-Houston Rockets game. How about them Sixers, man? You can say what you want about the Sixers, but, I mean, they've been hot. They've been playing good. They're getting 6.5 points tonight. We got to check if that guy, whatever his name is. I'm not sure what his name is. It's complicated. It's got an E. It's got a B. It's got two I's in it, another B. I don't know where this cat's from, but, boy, I tell you, he can play basketball. And if he's on the floor tonight, it's going to be hard not to take them 6.5, 7 points with the Philadelphia 76ers. So we got a lot to talk about the final 20 minutes of the program. So don't touch that dial, Cap. You're listening to Sportsline Radio with Dave the Meatman Scandaliato. And we're doing it all right here on 910 AM WUBR CBS Sports Radio, Baton Rouge. Yes, sir. What's going on? I gotta make a phone call here. Hello, can you hear me? I'm doing my Yeah, who's this? Well, would take. I'm doing my radio show now. Can I call you in 20 minutes? We're taking the Pelicans tonight plus six. We're gonna take the New Orleans Pelicans plus six against the Spurs. I'll talk to you later. All right, thank you, sir. Twenty more minutes, Don, and then you get to go home. Happiness. The listen live thing has been working a lot better. Just so you know, whatever that's worth. All right. And welcome back to Sportsline. My name is Dave, the Meatman Scandaliato, and I'm glad to be here. And I'm glad to have you there, brother. I'm glad to be here. I really appreciate Pelican Sports TV giving me the opportunity to bring you Sportsline Radio every Friday from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Central Time. Right here on 910 AM WUBR CBS Sports Radio in Baton Rouge. I was able to take a break and not talk about the NBA because both of my games don't start until 7 o'clock Central Time. So we got plenty of time. We got plenty of time here to get down. We got plenty of time to get down here, and let's see if there's been any movement on the LSU line. Let's see if there's been any movement here. It opened 16, and the Sharps and the Wise guys came in, and they pounded it down to 15.5. They pounded it down to 15.5. Let's see if it's moved. Let's see if it's moved any. Let's see, boom, bada bing, ba, boom, ba. Looking at the thing here. And, no, still 15.5. And, 154.5. I don't know, man. I mean, I don't know. I mean, anytime LSU's played this year, and there's been a big point spread, they've gotten crushed. I mean, that's the only way you could describe it. I mean, they were getting 10.5 at Auburn. They didn't get crushed there, but Auburn sucks. I mean, the bottom line, Auburn sucks. You know, you got to give LSU credit. I mean, they have covered 4 out of their last 10, so it's not like they're printing money betting against them. But, I mean, you know, once again, Wake Forest gave LSU 10 points. LSU lost by 34. Texas A&M gave them 12. LSU lost by 30. Auburn gave them 10.5. LSU lost by 4. Arkansas was giving them 14.5. And LSU lost by 13. And then the other day, Florida was giving them 11.5. And LSU lost by 35, so I don't know. LSU is 2-0 against Texas Tech in our recent meetings. They beat them in 2013 at Texas Tech. The final score was 71-69. In that game, LSU was a 3-point favorite on the road. And Texas Tech covered the three. They were getting the three. They lost by two. And then in the following year, 2014, LSU was a 7.5-point favorite. The game went to overtime, and the Tigers won the game 69-64. So the last two times they played, the only two times that they played, LSU won both games. It's hard to believe you can go from a 3-point favorite in December of 2013 at Texas Tech to a 7.5-point favorite at home against Texas Tech in November of 2014. And now here we are in January of 2017, and LSU's getting 15.5 points. I mean, man, that's amazing. That's amazing. I mean, that's like a 20-point swing. That's like a 20-point swing. And, I mean, let's be brutally honest. Texas Tech, they're not that good. I mean, they're 14-6 on the season, but they are 12-1 at home. LSU's 1-4 on the road, so that's what the problem is. That's what the problem is. LSU's road record is bad. Texas Tech's home record is pretty good. And Texas Tech just lost at Baylor the other day, 65-61. Texas Tech has lost three out of their last four. They've lost four out of their last six. And they've lost, five out of their last eight. So, I mean, it's a very beatable team. I mean, you know, you lose five out of your last eight. I mean, come on, man. I mean, you're just not that good. Now, they're playing teams like Baylor, Oklahoma State, TCU, Oklahoma, Kansas State, Kansas, West Virginia, Iowa State. So, I mean, their level of competition is a lot tougher than LSU's. LSU's played some decent teams, but you really can't compare what LSU's been playing up against Texas Tech. So, 15.5, 154.5. The game tips at 1 o'clock Central Time. And then, once again, immediately following the game, the post-game show, sponsored by Pelican Sports TV, Tommy Chrysan, Jordy Holberg, taking your phone calls, taking your text messages. It's an hour-long program. It's like a jazz funeral without the band. 9:10 a.m. WUBR CBS Sports Radio, Baton Rouge, will carry the post-game show live. And, of course, you can watch it in over 1 million homes throughout the state of Louisiana on Pelican Sports TV. All right, let's talk a little National Basketball Association. The association. Let's talk a little association. I was 2-0 last week right here on the program. 2-0. How do you like that? That's almost impossible to do. It's almost impossible to do this. But I did it. 2-0 last week right here on the program. Can we go 2-0 again? Can we do it again? Can we go 2-0 one more time? I can tell you right now, folks, the hottest team in the NBA is the Philadelphia 76ers. A lot of people are saying, "Meat man, go take another hit." Because obviously, you need it. Nah, I don't need another hit. The Sixers have won 8 out of their last 10 games. They won 8 times. They covered the spread in all 8 games. And the 2 times that they lost, they didn't cover the spread. Now, tonight they play in the Houston Rockets. And I'll be the first guy to admit, the Rockets, they kind of own the Sixers. They've beaten them 6 straight times. And, you know, sometimes it's close, sometimes it's not close. You know, the last time they played, Houston beat them by 27. But a couple of times before that, Houston won by two. Houston won by one. So, you know, you don't know what you're going to get. But look, this Philadelphia 76ers team's not that bad. And if there's one thing we've learned over the last week, that's the Houston Rockets are a very beatable team. They've lost three out of their last four. They've lost four out of their last six. And they've lost six out of their last 10. Now, this is a Houston Rockets team that a lot of people thought might be flirting with getting home court advantage throughout the Western Conference. Obviously, it's tough to do when you're in the same conference with the Golden State Warriors and the San Antonio Spurs, but you got to do a little better than winning four out of your last 10. That ain't going to get it. Yeah, you'll get in the playoffs in the Western Conference because the Sixers, well, we'll talk about the Sixers in a minute, but the Rockets are 34-15 straight up. So, I mean, there's no danger of them not making it into the playoffs. But I don't think they got much of a shot of the home court. Once again, when you lose 6 out of 10, because Golden State, they don't lose but 6 out of 40. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Golden State right now is 39-7. 39-7. And the San Antonio Spurs are 36-9. So those are the two teams that have a pretty firm grip on 1-2. The Houston Rockets, if the playoffs did start today at 34-15, they would take the 3 spot. But it's all about the 1 spot, man. I tell you, it's tough to beat a team when they got home court advantage. And like I said, through the first 30 games of the season, the Houston Rockets actually flirted with being the best team in the Western Conference, especially when they won that game against the Golden State Warriors, but they've come back down to earth a little bit. Like I said, losing 6 of their last 10. The Philadelphia 76ers have been hot. Now, look, I know betting on a team that's 17-27, that'll put you in a poorhouse, but you got to remember, they're 8-2 their last 10. So this team was 9-25 before the 8-2 run. And believe me, the way it's set up right now, if the playoffs started today in the Eastern Conference, obviously you'd have the Toronto Raptors, the Boston Celtics, the Cleveland Cavaliers, the Atlanta Hawks, and the Washington Wizards, and then everybody else is 500 ball. And with 38 games to go, I mean, the Sixers have just as good a chance of making it to the playoffs as the New York Knicks or the Chicago Bulls or the Charlotte Hornets. So, I mean, you got to watch out for the Sixers. So we're going to take the Philadelphia 76ers tonight. They're getting 6.5 points. We're going to buy it a half a point, and we're going to knock it up to 7. And that's what we'll do right there. The first play for the program today, we'll take the Philadelphia 76ers plus the 6.5, buy the half a point, knock it up to 7. Now the other game, we got the Pelicans and the San Antonio Spurs, and we just had a big, big line movement as the game is now at 7. Let me see if Anthony Davis is still playing. Let's see if he's still playing, because that's a big difference right there. Anthony Davis has upgraded to probable Friday versus San Antonio. And Kawhi Leonard, he's questionable tonight for San Antonio. I tell you what, man, no Kawhi Leonard. Anthony Davis plays for the Pelicans. I'd take them 7 points. I'd take that all day. When I started the program at the Westgate, the Pelicans were just getting 6. They were getting 6, so now they're getting 7. I'm going to take that. I'm going to take that. Believe me, there's a lot of goofy stuff going on with the point spread there, because some places have it at 7. Some places still have it at 5.5 bookmaker. They opened it at 5.5. They're settled in right now at 6. The total opened 208. And now it's 211.5. So we have had a 3.5-point line movement on the over-under total. But I'm taking the Pelicans tonight, man. I'm taking New Orleans. I'm gonna take Anthony Davis. I hope he's playing. Hope he's playing, because if he isn't playing, look, the Pelicans beat the Cavaliers the other day without Anthony Davis. I don't know about this. I will say this about the Pelicans. They've beaten the Spurs at home 3 out of the last 4 times that they played. Now, the last time they played in New Orleans, the Spurs were a 9.5-point favorite, and they won the game 94-86. So the last 4 times that New Orleans has played San Antonio in the Smoothie King Center, the Pelicans have won 3 out of the last 4 straight up, dating back to December the 26th, 2014, and have covered the spread in all 4 of those games. So I got a little history on my side here. The Pelicans always play the Spurs tough at home, and let's hope once again that'll happen tonight. So just 2 plays on the program today. Give me the New Orleans Pelicans plus the 7, and I'm going to take the Philadelphia 76ers plus the 6.5. I'm going to buy the 0.5. I'm going to make that plus 7. So 2 teams tonight, 2 plays, both plus 7 in the NBA, and both games tip off about an hour and 10 minutes from now. All right, that is pretty much going to wrap it up for this edition of Sports Line Radio. Don't forget, next Friday, 5 to 6 p.m., I'll be broadcasting live from Las Vegas, Nevada, the sports and gaming capital of the United States of America, from the Circus Hotel and Casino, a.k.a. the Clown Joint. Yep, they don't know I'm going to be doing this, so don't tell anybody. It's going to be a secret. It's a secret. I'm going to broadcast from my hotel room. Ha ha! They probably charge me a royalty. They want to charge me to park. They want to charge me to piss. They'll probably charge me to do a radio show. So we're going to keep it a secret. But boy, we're going to have a good time next week. I'm going to have all the props. I'm going to have sheets coming out of my yin yang, baby. I'm going to have all sorts of stuff for us to get down and get funky with on a Super Bowl Sunday. Hey, look. You need a place to bet some props on a Super Bowl Sunday? You need to talk to somebody who's been in the business for 20-plus years? Give me a call, 702-609-0930, 702-609-0930. You're going to talk directly with me, the Meat Man, Dave Scandaliato, owner of the meatandpotatoes.com website. I opened it back in 1998. Just a year and a half away from celebrating 20 years in business. All right, as always, I want to thank my man Don back in the studio. Don's going home. He's had a tough week. Tough week listening to everybody cry and bitch about LSU basketball and this and that and the other thing. But, hey, Don's going to get 48 hours away from the studio. I want to thank my man TK for giving me a chance. And, of course, Alan, the owner of Pelican Sports, for put me in the game. Don't forget, next Friday, 5 p.m. to 6 p.m., I'm broadcasting live from Las Vegas. As always, I want to thank everybody for tuning in. My name's Dave, the Meat Man, Scandaliato. Have a great weekend, everybody. All right, thank you, sir. Next week, I'll be in Las Vegas, Sin City. I'll have a couple of whores in the room with me when I'm doing a show. I should have said that. A couple of whores in the room. You ladies, you ladies need to be quiet for a minute while I'm doing a show. Before we get the program started, I need to tell these two prostitutes that I have in the room with me to be quiet for a little while. I agree with that, man. What's that humming sound in the background? Must be technical difficulties. Must be. Yes, sir. I'll see you next week. Thanks, Don. All right. You just listen to Sportsline Radio. My name is Dave, the Meat Man Scandaliato. You're going to watch this on YouTube at YouTube.com. Don't forget, we broadcast live every Friday, 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Central Time, 9:10 a.m. WUBR CBS Sports Radio, Baton Rouge. And, of course, you can listen live to the program on PelicanSportsTV.com. That's PelicanSportsTV.com. Thanks for watching. As always, my name is Dave the Meatman Scandaliato, and I'll see you in 167 hours right here on Sportsline.